Hey guys, it's Lotus and welcome back to another video. So today I found this video featuring the cast of All of Us Are Dead and they are playing a chat room game. I thought it was something really interesting to check out and so I wanted to share it with you guys. So it's from this channel called Pixid, P-I-X-I-D. I have watched a few of their videos before where they sometimes have celebrity guests on there and they are in a room with a few other people. And they have to be in a chat room. They all join a chat room and they have to figure out who's the odd one out. So kind of like, you know, Among Us, Town of Salem, werewolves, that type of thing. One of them doesn't belong in the chat room and you have to figure out who doesn't belong. So for example, I watched their most recent one with Jay Park because Jay Park just had his comeback with Ganadara featuring IU. So he was in this chat room with a bunch of high school rappers and he was the odd one out because he's not in high school. And they had to kind of suss each other out to figure out who is not supposed to be in this chat room. And I also watched one with, I think it was Tiffany from Girls' Generation. And they had one with Key. Now, that one is really, really funny. It was a chat room full of fangirls of Key from SHINee, plus Key himself. So he joined the chat group and he had to pretend to be a fan of himself and trick the others into believing that he is one of them. And that they'd have to vote out someone who's actually a real fan. So the person wins if they aren't voted out of the group, and they lose if they are found out. So that's essentially the premise. But the difference is that they don't talk to each other. They don't make any eye contact or verbal contact. They can only communicate with each other within the messaging group. So it depends, I guess, on how well you're able to write and interact with others. If you can use the same type of lingo and slang that the others use, then you'll probably be able to make your way through. But if you are not up to date with texting language, you probably will be considered sus. So let's see. In this one, the title is Find the Survivors in the Zombies Chat Room, featuring All of Us Are Dead Netflix. Now, I wonder how this is going to work, because normally it's pretty obvious who the survivor is supposed to be and who the odd one out is just by looking at them. But I wonder how they're going to do this, because there aren't actually any zombies. So I don't know how they're going to go about finding out who's a zombie survivor when there aren't any zombies to begin with. So let's see. Let's jump right into it. They're asking this guy, have you ever imagined yourself as a zombie?
네, 상상해본 적 있죠.
Yes, of course I have. I've dreamed of them.
있는데요?
Really? A lot of people have imagined... Well, actually, to be fair, I've had a lot of zombie dreams before, too. A zombie virus has spread through the set. They must survive the game in order to survive in real life. Zombie-obsessed chat. I pause. Okay. So... Oh, okay. So we have the two lead... actors from All of Us Are Dead. We have the actor that plays Eunjo and the actor that plays Cheongsan. And we have three zombies. So these are the two zombie survivors and these are the three zombies. How are they going to go about texting in the group chat though? What are they supposed to talk about? Okay. Moderator, hi, this is a chat for the zombie obsessed. You can only converse through chat. There are survivors in the room who aren't zombies. Can you find who they are just by chatting with them? I get deep into the character of Nam Eunjo, who she plays in All of Us Are Dead. I use what I saw and learned in the drama, so let's see how they do. Can they trick the zombies? That they're also a zombie? Yeah, immerse yourself, become the zombie. Round 1, self-introductions. Let's guess each other's identities. Okay, her name is Serum, his name is Happy Like Me. Oh, like a happiness virus? Humans are tasty? Wi-Fi? Let's play zombie? Okay. Yeah, let's all be chingus. We need to find the vaccine, let's not talk casually. And of course there is. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's see. What are they gonna do? Guys, let's see. How are you gonna trick them? Why is your name Wi-Fi? My favorite zombie is the one in the ad for Wi-Fi. What? What ad? What ad is this? An ad with a Wi-Fi obsessed zombie? Haven't you seen The Dead Don't Die? Oh, I've never seen that show. I've never seen that movie before. I try to just pass it off as if I've seen it before. why did you have to mention the title? Feels like you're trying to show off. Why are you guys getting up on me? I thought they would have heard of it at least once. He's trying to show off that he is a zombie connoisseur. He knows a lot of zombie movies. Okay, let's see. Oh no. Everyone's gonna think he's suspicious. It's so obvious that he looked it up. Why do you sound like Google Translate? Does he really sound like that? Wait, do they know each other? Pause. Do they know each other? Like, does Eunjo and Cheongsan's actor both know that they are both participating? Do they know that each other are the survivors, or do they also not know themselves? Because that would be really awkward. Okay, so Cheongsan's use. I'm gonna refer to them by their characters' names because, again, I'm sorry guys, I forgot the actors' names. I'm really bad with them with names, but yeah, Cheongsan. His username was Happy, right? Because he's like a happy virus, and virus equals zombie virus. So let's see, what is his profile pic? I didn't even pay attention. I hope everyone is happy in life. Oh, huh? Oh, the resurrection plant from Kingdom. Yeah, from the Netflix show Kingdom. So he has a picture of a flower for his profile pic. Oh, that's so cute. Someone has like an actual zombie as their icon. Oh no, are they turning on Cheongsan now? He just Googled? 아니고, 나도 좀비다. 좀 솔직하게 말씀드리면은 그때 살짝 좀 의심이 갔어요. X or triangle? Okay, so she does know that he's also participating, yeah. So he chats like he's in a Google Translate app. She's gonna throw him under the bus? Wait, what was the question? Let me just go back, sorry. The person you love is bitten by a zombie in front of your eyes. What choice do you make? Oh no, that's so hard. Cheongsan says... Okay, so she would get bitten. He would want to survive. I'd lock her in my room and go look for the vaccine. That's smart. Leave in a safe place and quickly start looking for a cure. That's what most people do in zombie movies, right? You guys are so romantic. Your answers show that you're truly zombie obsessed. Should we create a zombie society? Oh, they're being all like friendly. That's so cute. Zombie version Baskin 31. Hands down, you haven't been shot in the shoulder before. Everyone's writing so fast, it's hard to keep up. Same. Round one is over. Oh no, Cheongsan, right? Is probably. Yep. They think that he's really. Cheongsan! Ooh, okay. So, Cheongsan so far. It's not me, guys. I'm not the survivor. She's turning on him? Do you know the difference between American and Korean zombie movies? Oh, no. Korean and American zombies. That's true. Right? If you've watched, if you watched Kingdom, Train to Busan, All of Us Are Dead, or Hashtag Alive, all of the Korean zombies run really, really fast. They're really agile, really flexible. They can also climb really well. They have really good cognitive reactions. I don't know. That's what's really scary about Korean zombies. As opposed to American zombies like, let's say, The Walking Dead, they actually walk really, really slow. They're scarier looking, I think, because in The Walking Dead, they like to do, like, they really go really in on the zombie makeup. And so it's like flesh falling off. So it's very gory, viscerally. But in terms of being chased, you wouldn't want to be chased by a Korean zombie. Okay, let's see. It's obvious he prepared the answer in advance. Oh no, they're all ganging up on him. Have you ever seen a real zombie? We're the zombies. Just look in a mirror. Round two, A to Z zombies. What's your favorite zombie show? Ooh, okay, let's see. The Walking Dead, I Am Legend, All of Us Are Dead. Aww. Hmm. Okay, so a lot of them have watched All of Us Are Dead. Uh-oh, what's wrong? What's wrong? Someone doesn't know the show? They're like, never heard of it. Is that some field of study? You seriously don't know the zombie drama that's releasing on January 28th? Oh no, Chung-san! You're going too hard in right now. You're like, he's like sending a press article and everything. I didn't know what they were talking about. Oh, he wasn't familiar with the abbreviated title. That's fair. Sometimes you don't know the abbreviation for stuff. Your house is surrounded by zombies. How would you survive? Okay, guys. If your house... Well, actually, I want to ask you guys the same question. So, what would you do if your loved one was turned into a zombie? I really don't know what I would do. Honestly, I think, first of all, I would try to lock them and separate and isolate them. You try to restrain them, right? First of all, you got to make sure that you're safe. So like wrap up your arms and make sure you're wearing protective gear and make sure that there's nowhere that they can bite you so that you can get turned. Then you would try to like subdue them, tie them up and lock them up to make sure that they can't hurt others. But also make sure that they won't get slain by zombie hunters, because you don't want them to die either. Plus, if there's a cure, then you want them to be around for that cure, right? But yeah, I would probably try to... I don't know, I'm a scaredy cat. I'll be honest with you, in this scenario, it'd probably be too late. I have really slow reflexes. I'd probably end up bitten before I know it, and I will end up turning too. Which, you know what? That's okay. I feel like in a real zombie apocalypse, I'd be one of the first to turn. And you know what? That's okay. Not everyone can be a survivor. You gotta just go with the flow, right? As for the second question, what is your favorite zombie movie? My favorite zombie movie? I don't know. I like quite a lot. I haven't watched a lot of Western ones in a while. So in terms of like Korean ones, then definitely Train to Busan is one of my all-time favorite zombie movies and all-time favorite like thriller movies in general. Like I always cry at the end. Like, you don't expect a zombie movie to make you cry, but I cry every single time I watch the ending of Train to Busan, and I've watched it many, many times. And then the third question was, what would you do if your house was surrounded by zombies? What would I do? I would secure all the doors, all the entranceways, all the windows, anything that they could, any opening that could allow them to get into the house, I would make sure it's sealed up. I would make sure I take inventory of all the food in my house. Make sure you have enough water. Make sure that as long as you have enough to survive inside and then they can't get in, you just gotta wait for help, right? So it's always important during an apocalypse to get all your supplies and gear. And so if you are ever worried about an apocalypse, a zombie apocalypse happening, then do be sure to stock up on non-perishable goods. Okay, let's see what they have to say. What would they do if their house was surrounded by zombies? Okay, they're like, what kind of zombies? Korean zombies, the fast ones. The ones that can really run fast and really climb fast. We need a truck? Oh, to scavenge for food, okay. Okay, so yeah, you need to have a vehicle to get yourself to the grocery store. To get supplies. Yeah, you never have to pay in zombie movies. There's currency doesn't matter anymore. They're like, you don't have to worry about paying. The zombies have already taken over the store anyway. There's no more shop owner. Everyone seems like a zombie. Oh, so it's actually possible that there might not be any survivors in the chat and it could just be the moderator? Oh, another question. Select the character that will survive the longest. Wait. Select the character that will survive the longest in a zombie apocalypse. We have a convenience store owner. We have a veterinarian, a soldier, a stay-at-home loner, or a regular student. What do you guys think? What would you choose? Let's go through the options. A convenience store owner has a lot of pros because they are in a store stockpiled with food and perishables and supplies, so they'll have like food and water and They'll have cleaning supplies if they need to go to the bathroom. There's probably a bathroom in the convenience store, so you don't have to worry about that. Although you'd have to worry about, you're in an open space, a store, so you have to make sure that all the doors are sealed, and then you'd have to also worry about not being able to leave. You do have electricity, but then of course, when it goes out, what are you gonna do? You're not at home with your stuff. And you'd also have to fight probably with other humans who come in trying to scavenge the store. You'd have to either fight them or go with them. So there's pros and cons to being a convenience store owner during a zombie apocalypse. Number two is a veterinarian. That's really good because then you kind of know some medical stuff in case someone gets injured. Not of the bite variety. If you're bitten, it's kind of over for you. But in terms of like knowing how to treat wounds, non-life-threatening wounds, then being a veterinarian would be good. You know, probably first aid. I'm pretty sure veterinarians go to regular medical school too, right? Maybe? I'm not quite sure. But you're probably really smart and intellectual, or I'd hope so. So maybe being able to come up with a good plan for survival if you're a veterinarian. If you're a soldier, also really good, number three, because you have a lot of physical strength and probably endurance, which is important in a zombie apocalypse. If you have to run away or fight with weapons, you probably know how to use weapons if you're a soldier. So it'd be good to have that type of background and experience. Number four, a stay-at-home loner. So the thing is that in a lot of like horror, monster, zombie movies, often the main character is a stay-at-home loner. Like, for example, in the movie Hashtag Alive, the main character doesn't even realize that a zombie apocalypse initially started because he always stays home. And even in the K-drama Sweet Home, which isn't about zombies but about monsters, he ends up saving himself a little bit because he also never goes out, and so he avoids interacting with a lot of monsters at the beginning of the show. So being a stay-at-home loner has a lot of perks, unless you eat up everything and you have nothing left. Huh. So there's a pro and a con. Also, if you're always staying at home, you might not be in the best shape. So if you need to run or fight against zombies, you may be at a disadvantage. Finally, number five, a regular student. Of course, they're going to be partial because the show All of Us Are Dead features mainly high school students. I feel like generally in real life, I don't think being a regular student would have the best outcome compared to maybe some of the other roles that we've been given. But I guess for the sake of All of Us Are Dead, then being a student is the way to go. What do you guys think? Who of these five options do you think would survive the best in a zombie apocalypse? Not everyone else will. Everyone else will die while trying to help the loner. Oh, so he thinks the vet. He thinks the regular student, because he's a student. Yeah, exactly. If you're a convenience store person, you have a safe space and food. The convenience store will be raided by humans. Yeah, also that's true. Also, the doctor might be taken hostage. The veterinarian might be taken hostage. I choose number five then. I want to see the children survive. Yeah, you end up getting emotionally attached to students. Students tasting. Jeong-san, why would you say that? Aigo. Oh, now they're all just like kidding around now. They're calling him a boomer now? Okay, trying to figure out the imposter again. Are they gonna vote?
집에서 별명이 박재민이거든요. 요즘 막 어쩔 TV 이런 거 많이 하잖아요. 근데 이제는 어쩔 시크릿 주주 리미티드 에디션.
아, 이 친구도 MZ 세대가 맞구나.
Generation MZ? Oh, like millennial Gen Z cusp. 정선. I mean, Cheong-san is the survivor, but still, I guess he's not that great at acting in this situation. Okay, let's see. Who are you happy? This is betrayal. Oh, round three. Watching the following footage and say what should be done next. Oh, this is the rat scene. What would you do in this situation? Aigo, oh my gosh. You know, if this happened to me, if I was at school and this happened, I would simply just perish. You know what? I would simply just perish. A Train to Busan came true. I love how Train to Busan canonically exists and all of us are dead. Like, it actually exists as a movie. This is a really, really good show, by the way. If anyone has not watched it yet, please do go watch All of Us Are Dead. It is thrilling to the max, and you will be on your tippy toes for the whole time. It's really, really stressful to watch. And because the majority of the cast are kids, you do get attached to them and you feel bad for them because they're also going through teen angst and crushes and bullying and worried about their reputation and trying to be friends and, you know, right? Like, you know, stuff. Like, everyone goes through this, but especially if you're a student, you're a teenager, it's a stressful stuff. Your hormones are out of whack. You just want to go home and eat dinner and take a bath and, like, do homework and go to sleep. You don't want to have to deal with a zombie apocalypse. Man, I felt really bad for these students. I'd go hide somewhere. Same. Well, I definitely pair it with some people that I can trust because I would not want to be alone. Find a weapon and also find an adult. I would find an adult. find a trustworthy adult. Find a weapon. Find some people to stick with and then barricade somewhere. Auditorium is so big though. Yeah. Auditorium has a lot of doors. Would the rescue team check? The auditorium first? I don't know. Chalk dust is a smoke screen. That's kind of hard. Chung-san, you were in the show. What would you do? Lunch tray and fork. What are you gonna do with the lunch tray? Oh, is it because he is a zombie? So... He's like, as a zombie, he would want a lunch tray and a fork. So he can eat all the survivors. Or you could do that too. Let's see. Any questions for the imposter? Yeah, have you guys... I mean, I'm pretty sure everyone suspects Chung-san right now. Ooh. Who was Serum? Wait, him? Was he Serum? You guys have lost a friend. I think it's either happy or human. Well... Chung-san. Wait, did he accurately guess both of the survivors? Human and Happy are both Eunjo and Chung-san, right? I couldn't help him, so I had to sacrifice him. Oof. Throwing your friend under the bus. Can't trust no one in this house. I was left to fend for myself. Anya! Anoyo! What of the dead? What? Dawn of the Dead? It could be Shaun of the Dead, like the parody zombie movie. How many days later? 28 days, was it? It's 28 days. Uh-oh, he outed himself. Oh no. Oh wait, she said the wrong number too. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, they're gonna test Chung-san now? Time for the final votes. Who hasn't been infected yet in this chat? She voted for Chung-san herself? Oof. Bye, Happy. The stakes were... He's like, it was rigged from the start. Oh, I can't wait for them to meet them. Are they gonna talk about zombie movies together? Oh, prank time? Oh no. Na dulce? Oh, did they realize who they were? Oh, they weren't expecting to get scared. They're like, huh? He wasn't prepared. Do they recognize them though from the trailer? He didn't commit to the bit.
He's
so sweet! Aww. He's such a sweetheart.
추억 하나씩 가지고 이제 집으로 돌아가요.
그러면 저희를 속이시.
So yeah, yeah. Did you trick us then? Were you trying to scare us? Oh, do they not recognize them from the? Oh, that's so cute. So did they not recognize them from the trailer? They literally just watched the trailer. I mean, I guess maybe because they're still considered newer actors that maybe they don't recognize them. But still, I bet after they watched All of Us Are, I guess that this little chat room video, I guess, came out before the show aired. So they don't recognize them. But after the show happens, I bet they're going to look back at this video and be like, damn, I should ask for their autograph. But I would kind of probably react the same way as Cheongsan. I'd be so confused. I'd be like, huh? What's going on? Yeah, so that was really fun to watch. I really liked the format that they did. So you can't hear each other's voice. So that doesn't give anything away. All you can do is chat in the group. But then also there's disadvantages because some people aren't really great at chatting in groups. I'm not that great. I get really awkward in group chats. So that could be a disadvantage. And then also it depends on like who takes charge of the group, because there could be someone who's more forward or forceful and they drive the conversation. And so if you don't get to really put a lot of words in, then people will be suspicious of you. So there's pros and cons to it, but it's a really fun idea, a fun take on the imposter game. But yeah, I really enjoyed this. I can't wait to see more. I wish they had more of the cast though. Like, I wish that we had the actor who played Gwinam and the actor that played Soo-hyuk and the actor who played Namra. But then I guess there'd be too many players, right? But I do want to see, it would be fun to see all of them play like a longer version of Werewolf with all of the characters, except instead of Werewolf or Mafia, it would be Zombie. Who's the zombie, right? But yeah, I'm still trying to think. I still don't think Netflix announced a season 2 yet, right? Looking at my watch, Netflix. Come on, any day now. It's doing so well in Korea and overseas. What's taking you so long? It ain't that hard, buddy. Please renew it for season 2. Onegai shimasu. Please. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's video that I found. I thought it was really fun. Also, do check out Pixid because they have a lot of other fun videos, chat room videos, to find out the imposter. And of course, with some of them, the celebrity guests are more well known. So it's really fun to see the reactions of the participants when they find out that, oh my gosh, I was texting like Key from SHINee. Or I was texting Tiffany from Girls' Generation, or I was texting Jay Park. Like, you know, it's really fun to see the reaction because a lot of them are actually fans. So it's like their dream come true. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy today's video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye!